Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, The Legend of Heroes. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We just killed a giant boar, the two of us, Jurio and Chris. I'm gonna bring it back to home, to Jurio's home. Jurio's father says, "Good work. This is a big, magnificent boar. Now you sent your son into danger. Horrible father. I thought you'd give up. Good job, son." His mother says, "Chris is here too. Good timing. Why don't you go and talk to the mayor before it gets too late? I'll have the feast ready by the time you get back." Jurio says, "Let's get rid of the boring stuff. Chris, let's go." "Okay." Okay. Sometime later, Mayor Tolta says, "Oh, Jurio and Christina, let's talk a bit about tomorrow's pilgrimage." Mrs. Pruna says, "It may get a bit long, but hear him out. Now, Jurio and Christina, tomorrow you're both going on the pilgrimage, your coming-of-age ceremony. But you know what you have to do, right?" "No? That's a good boy. Now listen. There are 5 shrines that have existed for a long time in the Tirasweel area." Hopefully I'm saying that right. "There's a magic mirror in each of the shrines. You have to go to each mirror and look into it. This is the coming-of-age ceremony and the pilgrimage. All the people in Ragpick Village have become adults by doing this." Chris says, "Which one shall we go to first?" "The shrine in Dean. After that, listen to the sages and head towards Oldos. You will view the last magic mirror in Oldos. That is the objective of this pilgrimage." Okay, so it's Dean, something, 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 Oldos. Jurio says, "How far away is Oldos?" It's funny, the uppercase O's look like zeros. "It's going to be a long trip. A month, or maybe a month and a half. Coming back is troublesome, too. When you leave Oldos, the boats from Neri won't be sailing because of the ice. You'll have to return to Folthia by the west route. You'll probably be back in this village in about 3 months." 3 months? What are we going to do for money all that time? "Oh, you could just pull it out of boar's behinds. We've made quite a bit of money that way already." "Don't worry about that. All people who go on the pilgrimage must have the Silver Dagger with them. As long as you have that, all stays at inns and boats will be free of charge. Also, it serves as a pass to get through checkpoints." "What's a checkpoint? What is this sorcery?" "You just have to go on the pilgrimage at your own pace. The purpose of the pilgrimage isn't just to complete it." Okay, so it's the journey. "It's what you find by going on a trip like this. I guess that's all I have to say. Rest up today. I'll give you the Silver Dagger tomorrow before you leave." "In other words, we can do whatever we want during the trip, right?" "Chris, be sure to keep an eye on Jurio. Don't let him out of your sight. Now go home and be ready for tomorrow. Get a good night's rest. You have a big day tomorrow. See you later, Jurio. I'm going home then." "Okay, see you tomorrow." Okay, so it's just us again. Or just him. "Nervous? I was like that too. You must rest for tomorrow." First, we'll talk to everybody. Mrs. Peruna says, "The views seen in the magic mirrors are beautiful, but the memories of the people you meet along the road are important, too." Okay. Chris says, "I'll come and get you tomorrow morning. Let's go see the mayor together. I'm gonna beat you up if you oversleep." She's a toughie, huh? Chris's mother. Eat regular meals. You'll feel uneasy if you get sick while on the pilgrimage. I imagine these people have names. What's this here? Something trying to get our attention. Okay. Do you want to listen to Mom's music box? You can if you want. I'm not sure why we want to listen to the music box. I mean, it's nice enough. Jurio says, it's always such a pretty song. You think so too? I love the song. His father says, once you get across to Menarth by boat, it'll get cold, unlike Fothia. Don't catch a cold. Anything else to say about the music box? No, okay. See you tomorrow! Alright, before we go back home, I want to visit these other NPCs here. Still want to play? Yuri says, what? I'm a little tired. But you won't be here starting tomorrow, so let's play. If you don't play, I'll go down the wrong path in life and blame you. Really? I think this child will be lonely while Jurio is gone. He's lonely already, lady. Did you talk to the mayor? You'll receive the silver dagger tomorrow, then. Better get ready. I'm not opening tomorrow. Be sure to buy all you need today. What can I get for you? We can buy stuff? Oh. He's got cure potion. Yeah, we have these things. Marbles. Silver glass marbles treasured by Jurio. We have the money. Might as well get the marbles. Not enough money. Oh, he wants 5 platinum pieces. That must be what that is. Platinum? Well, I lost my marbles. And only you can give them to me. You jerk. Excuse me. Oh, this place is empty. This must be their house. I try to steal things, but the game won't let me. Is that everybody? No, there's somebody else. Yeah, that's his house. There's somebody else up here somewhere? Not the old man. I mean, I don't imagine he had anything new to say. There's somebody else, though. Why can't... Yeah, let me up. I love the music so much. Oh, yeah, you! You! Raj! Oh, Jurio, the mayor asked me to fix this fence. So you're fixing a window and now you're fixing his fence. I guess the mayor talked a lot again, huh? He easily ambles over 3 hours when I talk to him. Is there anything else to say? Isn't there, like, one other person? I wasn't even thinking of Raj. I think I forgot about somebody. Somebody with a strange name. But I don't know. I don't see anybody else out here. Alright, let's go home. Yurio's mother says, okay then, let's celebrate for Jurio. The great boar stew is ready to eat. Father says, I can't believe that crybaby Jurio is already off to his pilgrimage. Where's the time gone? Dad, I'm right here. Mother says, I know, honey. Cheers to our son. Cheers. They talk about him like he's not here. Jurio says, bottoms up. So the eve of the pilgrimage went on. Is that Chris? Is it morning now? Jurio! Hey, Jurio! I'm sorry, Chris. You've come to get him, but he just woke up. I knew it. Mother says, oh, your clothes are so pretty. You look so cute. Hehe. My mom made it for me. Father says, I don't know if he's confident or he's just stupid to be oversleeping on a day as important as this. Yawn. I don't know. I haven't played this, guys. This is all blind. From, beginning of this episode. Completely blind. Good morning, Chris. What do you mean, good morning? If you're like this during the pilgrimage, I'm going to leave you. Mother says, here, wake up. Be sure not to offend the mayor. We'll be joining you later. I just saw a bard. It's kind of rare to see a bard in the village, isn't it? A bard? She was a really pretty young lady. Where's the bard? Up there? Oh, there they are. Oh, Raj, you came too? Jurio says. Of course. You think I'd miss out on this? Look, the mayor is here too. Chris says, the mayor? Mayor says, yeah, don't worry about it. After her song, we're going to start the presentation of the Silver Dagger. Raj says, hey, check her out. She's pretty. A bit too much makeup, but she is pretty. I don't criticize her makeup. The bard goes, ahem. Thank you for waiting. I'm going to play my favorite ballad. Woohoo! We've been waiting for this, Raj says. Well, here it goes. It goes a little something like this. Even you forgot. The ancient memory comes back with... her words. Please tell the scar that won't heal, the sin that we left. Is this advancing by itself? Okay, yeah, I'm gonna put this down. To the earth? The sin that we left to the earth. People will forget, but it will live. Forever in our hearts. Who's that? Does he have a... Traveler says, Shirla, look, it worked. We got the silver dagger. Oh, I thought he was going to attack her with the dagger. Does stealing the dagger, the two of them? Oh no, the bard says. Raj says, the silver dagger? The bard says, you dork! Why do you think I was attracting all the people's attention? Chris says, the silver dagger. You mean the one we were supposed to take? Crap, now we're going to have to pay to stay at inns and stuff. Wonderful. Jurio says, what? Then who are these people? Yeah, if you guys don't... was that... I think it was in the previous episode when they told us. What was it in this one? Yeah, with the silver... Yeah, it was just in this episode. With the silver dagger, we stay for free at inns and get free boat rides, but now they're taking it. Jurio says, what? Then who are those people? Raj says, they're thieves. She is pretty. The bard says, goose, don't just sit there looking stupid. Run! His name's Goose. Like, I don't have an opportunity to chase him. Gotta go after them, Chris says. Yeah, Jurio says. Mayor! Mayor says, oh no, trouble. No kidding. Oh no, trouble. Maybe the old man will stop them. Ooh. Hey, watch it, Grandpa! Traveler, or aka Goose, says. I almost fell off the cliff. Well, it would have served you right. Hurry, Goose! We dropped the dagger. What a dangerous couple. What on earth are they in such a hurry for? What's that? They dropped such an expensive-looking dagger. Hey, you two, wait! Nope, already gone. Well, this guy's clueless. At least they left in such a hurry. Grandpa Lap, Jurio says. What happened, Jurio? Chris, you look upset. The bard was conspiring with the traveler who was the singing thief. What are you talking about? Calm down. Sorry, Chris says. Jurio doesn't make sense when he's panicked. Is that true? What happened was that the couple you just saw stole the silver dagger. Oh no, that's terrible. What's in your hand, Grandpa Lap? This? A couple dropped it when they passed by me earlier. Chris says, isn't it the silver dagger? That's right. No wonder it looked familiar. Tell the truth, I quickly took it from the young fellow while he wasn't paying attention. Don't lie! Chris says, now you're going too far, but you did bring us back the silver dagger. Thank you, Grandpa Lap. Don't mention it. Raj says, it's too late. Don't worry. Here it is. You need it for the presentation. Take it with you. How did you do it, Grandpa Lap? Let's see. I grabbed the collars of the young fellow who came attacking me, and then threw him to the ground in a single breath like this. Oh, brother. Mayor says, Jurio, Christina, it's time to leave. We must start the presentation of the silver dagger. I'm glad it wasn't stolen. Let's go back to the village. Hey, stay and listen to my story. Raj says, Grandpa Lap, you need to learn how to lie better. Thanks a lot. That was awesome. The mayor says, what kind of terrible people are they to try and steal the silver dagger? This dagger is the proof of pilgrims. You can't travel without it. Watch out for thieves during your journey. Let's cheer ourselves up and start the presentation of the silver dagger. I have a feeling we'll be seeing those two again, and they might try to steal the dagger again. Ahem. Jurio and Christina, I, the mayor of Ragpick Village, shall hereby send you off on a coming-of-age pilgrimage. So wind will deliver your breath and fire warm your body. So earth will provide you with food. And I guess water to drink, yeah, will complete the elements. Yeah, water ease your fatigue each day, so heaven will watch over you in smiles. I shall hereby confer upon you the silver dagger. We should each get our own silver dagger, whatever separated. Jurio and Chris says nothing. Jurio received the dagger. Mrs. Pruna says, go, you two, in lively spirit. Head for Dean. Make good memories as you go. The mayor says, once pilgrims leave the village, they can't come back until they have visited all shrines. You should remember this rule. But, so we can't buy his marbles. Jurio's father says, well, I just want to say, you take care of yourself. His mother says, don't put Chris in danger, all right? I know. I'll be fine. I should go now. Jurio's father says, Jurio, come back safely, and sobs. Really? He was such a hard ass to him before. Now he's sobbing. Mother says, don't cry, my dear. I now understand how my father felt when I left. Mother says, I know, but your father didn't cry. Chris's father says, you really should take care of yourself. If you're in trouble, you can go to the chapels to get help. Mother says, your brother lives in Raguna, doesn't he? The father says, oh yes, Huck. With an H, Huck, okay. If you're in a big trouble, maybe you should go and ask him for help. He's a little eccentric, but he'll help you. Sounds interesting already. Chris, look after yourself. Mother, father, goodbye. Chris, Jurio says. Jurio, this will be a long journey. We'll help each other along the way. Jurio and Chris are now pilgrimage partners. Yay! We can talk to everybody! Let's talk to the mayor. After this journey, you'll be officially declared adults. You may face difficult situations, but don't give up. Wait, I'm trying to get around. Mrs. Peruna says, cross the bridge over the Crystal Lake and you're in Dean. It won't take you long, even if you walk slowly. Alright, let me just look up here, see if there's anyone hanging around. Nope. Well, that's the mayor's house. I think everyone's gathered. I think those are the only two houses up here. Alright, let's talk to the other people. Chris's father says, don't just think about your own purpose. Learn to be generous to others. The mother says, promise to us to come back in good health, both of you. They didn't promise. Jurio's father says, just come back safely, okay? And the mother says, be careful not to drink tap water. Don't drink tap water. That's pretty random. Tiana says, you're 1 year younger than her, but you must take the lead if you two are ever in danger, Jurio. It's a man's job to protect a woman. Oh, fiddlesticks. Skull, that's the one I was looking for before. I couldn't find him. So long. You'll be homesick for a while, but you'll soon get used to it. He doesn't say anything else, okay. Now the kid, where's the little kid? Is someone kidnapping him? I mean, kidnapping. Is someone, taking care of him? Yeah, I hope someone didn't kidnap him. Nothing here I can steal while people are away. Someone over there? Wait a second. Oh, it's Raj. You'll meet many people during your journey. They say, travel with a good companion and help each other along the way. Treat those whom you'll meet with sincerity. They may be able to help you when you're in trouble. Also, some monsters leave precious ore called Lapica behind. Bring it to any toolsman, and he'll buy it from you. If you find a lot of Lapica, you might just be able to travel richly. Sweet. I'll keep an eye out for this Lapica. Still looking for that little kid. Maybe it has been kidnapped. Alright, let's go visit the old man up here. Oh, wait. Almost didn't see you. Telno says, see the world to your heart's content. You'll find interesting things in different countries. If you come across delicious dishes, learn how to cook them and teach us. Okay. I'm sad I can't buy my marbles. Once you leave the village, you can't come back until you've completed your pilgrimage. Now then, are you prepared to leave? You say goodbye to everybody. Okay. I already did that. Yeah, I wanted to buy those marbles, but it'll take a lot of grinding to get, what is it, 5 platinum pieces? To get his marbles? So long. Maybe we'll get them at the end. You came at a good time. Come on in. Now, I shall give you a few words of advice, young Jurio and Chris, before departing for your pilgrimage. Now, you listen very carefully. After you leave the village, you'll encounter many events. Some are good, some are bad. No matter how undesirable the situation is, don't just remain depressed. Also, don't be nervous all the time, or disasters will come looking for you. Okay. No depression, no anxiety. Got it. Always be positive. It's that easy. That's the best way. Ryo says yes. Chris says I understand. Chris, I have something you should carry. Take this with you. Chris receives a lap staff. Isn't it something important to you, Grandpa Lap? Chris says. Well, it is an oak staff I was using a long time ago. It has recently been my wash line pole, so I don't mind you taking it. Thank you, Grandpa Lap. Yo-Yo says, Grandpa Lap, do you have anything for me? Yes. I have just the right thing for you. A new traveling companion. I got a bunny. It's about 14 in human years. Can you take it with you on your pilgrimage? Sure. Thank you, Jurio. I must tell you one thing. Don't expect too much from your pet. The best your pet can do is to pick up items on the roads, but you'll still find your pet helpful during your journey. I'll be waiting for your safe return, all three of you. Okay, I promise to come back safely with Chris and our pet after completing our pilgrimage. Does this pet have a name? Don't give the mayor too much trouble, Grandpa Lap. You talk like a grown-up already. Take care of yourselves during your journey. So long. Remember to keep your spirits up. Alright, so now we have this bunny that follows us around. Wait, we got this staff now. A gift from Old Lap, an ornate staff adorned with silver charms. So we've got the wooden staff. Look at that. Equipped. Hey, you! Grandpa Lap, you gonna tell us we're not supposed to go back to the village? You know pilgrims can't come back once they leave the village. Yeah, I just want to see what would happen. You won't grow up if you come back every time you feel lonely. Keep your spirits up. Just wanted to see. Okay. We're on our way. Kelly says, tell me about the journey when you come back. Okay. You'll be officially adults once you complete your pilgrimage. Do your best. I figured we'd do our worst, but... fine. So we're at Green Fields. Does that mean you picked something up? Wait. Right. I wonder if it did pick up another cure potion. What does that sound mean? Fire 3 and 1. A dagger used as identification for pilgrims doubles as an all-purpose pass. Okay. Someone is coming, Jurio says. Who are these rapscallions? Are they travelers? Chris says. Well, we're outnumbered. Shinon says, hello, you must be making a pilgrimage to the shrines. I come from Ambish with my family to meet Mr. Lap of Ragpick Village. You wonder what that noise means. You mean Grandpa Lap? Chris says. You know him? Of course I know him. He's even older than the mayor of our village. Is he in some kind of trouble? Shiara says, no, no, no. We were saved by Mr. Lap a long time ago. As you can see, Shinon says, our child is now old enough to travel with us, so we have to come see him. Jurio says, you saved your lives? Are you sure it's Lap that saved you? Shinon says, he is a great magician of Folthia. Why would I mistake him for anyone, for someone else? Chris says, a great magician? Shiara says, you didn't know? Jurio asks, are you sure he's a magician? 10 years ago, if Mr. Lap hadn't driven off those wolves, we wouldn't be here today. Shinon says, and our child as well. She wouldn't be here if it wasn't for him. Oh, is that Mr. Lap's staff your friend is holding? Shiara says. Yes, he gave me this. That's great, Shinon says. Mr. Lap must hold you in high regard, young lady. Why? I clearly remember that staff was often used by him when he was known as a great magician. Elpo says, Daddy, let's go meet Mr. Lap. Hurry. Yes, let's. Shiara says, by the way, there are many rude soldiers at the gate of Rudera, so please be careful. You're going to Dean first, aren't you? Shinon asks. Then you'll be safe, as long as you won't need to travel on the road to the capital. Well, we stopped you long enough. I hope your pilgrimage is a safe one. Take care. Goodbye. Elpo says, bye-bye. Well then. Chris says, I've never seen Lap use his magic. Jurio says, they say that you shouldn't judge a book by its cover, but this has got to be some kind of mistake. Yeah, you're right. Was it just a bird call or something? Or is that something that I need to be looking out for? Oh, Jurio found a mind potion. Okay. Should we go talk to Grandpa Lap, see if they're here with him? We're not coming back to the village, so... Me, a sorcerer? I may have been one, but I can't remember. Anyway, you have no time for this now. You must leave for Dean quickly, or you won't be able to come back soon. Shiara says, I'm relieved Lap is well for his age. He should be, as a great sorcerer. Shinon says, this is our first visit to Ragpick Village. It's a lovely place. Elpo says, I met a great sorcerer. I want to be a great magician, too, when I grow up. Maybe you will, kid. Maybe you will. Does that mean when that shows up, he's looking for stuff? And then when he finds something, he makes that annoying sound? See, I'm not here. Wait, now I'm hearing it again. So maybe it is like a bird call or something like that. Anyway, I'm going to call it an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.